Welcome dear students to lecture 8 of module 2 block diagrams and signal flow graphs. So in this question you have to find the transfer function using the Mason's gain formula. So here the signal flow graph is given. So first thing is we have to write the forward paths. Let us all identify the all different forward paths, then we will write it down. See, first forward path is this direct forward path from the input to the output. So gains will be G1, G2. This is the gain. This is one forward path. Next forward path is C. From here R, then it goes to G7, G8 and 1. This is one more forward path. Third forward path is C here. R from R1, then this G4 and here C. This is a third forward path. Next, fourth forward path from 1, G7, okay, then G6 and G2 and up to C. This is the fourth forward path. Fifth forward path from R, G1, then we go to G5, then G8 and 1. This is the fifth and the last forward path. So let me write down all the forward paths now with their forward path gains. So P1, it is G1, G2. Gains from R and C, it is 1, so I need not write. Okay, I'll just write the product of the gains there. So P2 is equal to G7, G8. P3 is equal to G4. P4 is equal to G7, G6, G2. P5 is equal to G1, G5, G8. So now we are done with the forward paths. Next, let us write the loop gains. So we'll identify how many loops are there first, then we will write the loop gains. See, one loop is this self loop, this is, that is G9. Another loop is again a self loop, that is G3. And one more is, see here, G5 and G6. So there are three loops. And this G9 and G3, these are non-touching loops. So now let us write the loop gains. So L1 is equal to G9, L2 is equal to G3, L3 is equal to G5, G6. Then two non-touching loops. So it is L1, L2, that is equal to G9, G3. Okay, so now we are done with the non-touching and non-touching loop. Now we have to write the Mason's gain formula. C of S by R of S. This is equal to P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 plus P3 delta 3 plus P4 delta 4 plus P5 delta 5 whole divided by delta. Now here we need to write what is delta. So delta is equal to 1 minus, we have L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L1 L2. So this is delta. Now let us write delta 1. So delta 1, what is the forward path? Delta 1 forward path is G1, G2. That is here, G1, G2. Okay, now out of these loops now, L1, L2, L3, which loop is not touching this forward path? This C, that is G9. This loop is not touching. G9 is nothing but L1. So all the other loops will become 0 and this will remain. So let us write that. So here we 1 minus L 1 or 1 minus G 9. Next, delta 2. Now, what is the second forward path? G 7, G 8. So now again, let us identify which is not touching G 7, G 8. So here, see R, G 7, G 8. So which loop is not touching G 7, G 8? See, G 4. This is not touching G 7, G 8. G 3 is not touching. So that is nothing but L 2. So here, delta 2 will be 1 minus L 2. So this is 1 minus G 3. Next, delta 3. Now, what is delta 3 path? Delta 3 path is G 4 from here. See, G 4. See, G 9 is also not touching. G 5, G 6 is also not touching. G 4 is also not touching. So, delta 3 will be the whole delta itself. L1, L2, L3 not touching. So, even L1, L2 product also we have to retain over there. So, delta 3 is nothing but directly the same value as delta. So, 1 minus L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L1, L2. I will substitute the values in the end. Okay. Next is delta 4. So, what is the delta 4 forward path? Delta 4 forward path is G7, G6, G2. See here. Now, here this node is common between this touching node. And G9 is touching this node and G3 is touching this node. If I talk about P5 forward path, that is G1, G5, G8. Again, this here it is touching L1 and here it is touching G2. So, G3. So, this is also touching. So, here delta 4 and delta 5, we have it as 1. So, now we have written all the values. Next step is just substituting in the given Mason's gain formula. So, let us substitute all the values and write what is C of S by R of S. So, C of S by R of S equal to, so here P1, G1, G3, delta 1, 1 minus G9 plus P2, G7, G8 and delta 2, 1 minus G3. P3 is plus G4, this is numerator only I am writing, whole of delta will come here, G9. Minus G3 minus G5 G6 plus G3 G9 plus P5, that is G7 G6 G2, delta 4 is 1 and P5 G1 G5 G8. This whole is numerator, whole divided by now the denominator. Delta 1 minus G9 minus G3 minus G5 G6 plus G3 G9. So this is the answer for the transfer function. Now here the question is, for the block diagram shown in figure, we have to obtain the transfer function using Mason's gain formula. That is the question. But Mason's gain formula is used for what? It is used for signal flow graph. This is block diagram. So first, what is the first step? We need to convert this given block diagram to signal flow graph. It's very simple. What you have to do is, wherever you have the summation points and these takeoff points, now those are considered as nodes. So we just number those nodes and the connections are visible over here. We just connect it as it is given, and the same way we do the connection, that's all. No much change. So we get a signal flow graph, then it is a normal procedure of writing the forward paths and the loop gains and proceed. Okay. So let me just number it. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Here takeoff point is 4, another takeoff point is 5, here this is 6 and this takeoff point is 7 and C of S. So you have 7 plus 2 nodes, the input node and the output nodes, RFS and COFS. And other connections we do by just looking at how it is connected in the block diagram, same way. This negative, you should be careful. You have to represent it as a negative only, even in the signal flow graph. So let us draw now. So first, let me just place all the nodes first. So we have 7 plus 2, 8, 9 nodes. So this is the input node, RFS. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So this is R, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and one extra I have written. Okay, so C of S. This is extra, so I don't need this. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and C of S. So these are the nodes what we need. And let me write the gains. So if there is nothing, no gain block as such, then it is 1. So between 1 and 2, we have it is 2 summation points, so gain will be 1. Between 2 and 3, we have a gain block, so it is G1. Between 3 and 4, again, it is, we don't have anything. I can write it 1 or leave it, no issues. Then between 4 and 5, we have a gain block. But gains, if it is there, that you have to write it, okay, without fail. Between 5 and 6, also you have another block. This is G3. And between 6 and 7, we have nothing. And here also, it is 1. Then, now let us do the other connections. Okay, now this gains you have written. So first, from 4 to 6 we have here. So where is 4? 4 is here and this is 6. So this is a forward path with again G4. Then this one, from 1 to 7 we have one connection. So we write it here. Yes, this is negative feedback. It is minus 1. Then 2 to 5 we have a connection. So 2 to, where is 5? Yes, here connected. And here what is it? It is minus H1. 3 to 7 we have a connection. 3 to, so I'll simply jump over here. Okay, it is not connected there. 3 to 7. So minus H2. And we are done with all the connections. Now we have to identify the forward paths and the loops. So first let us identify forward paths. One is a direct forward path from input to output. So what are the gains? G1, G2, G3. One more forward path. G1, then C, it goes via G4 and comes to the output C of X. So two forward paths. So let us write the forward path gains. So forward path gain. So here P1 is equal to straightforward path G1, G2, G3 and P2, it is G1, G4. Next, let us write the loop gains. Let us identify the loop gains. Loops first, then we'll write the loop gains. See, one is here. G1, it should start from the same point and end at the same point. So G1, G2 and minus 1. This is one loop. G1, G2, minus H1. This is one more. G2, G3, minus H2. This is one more. And one more. See here. G1, G4, and minus 1. Then one more here. From here, see, 1, G4, and this, and minus H2. This is also one more forward path, loop. So we have 5 loops. So let us write the 5 loops over here. So loop 1 is G1, yes, minus, it is minus G1, G2, H1, L2 is equal to minus G2, G3, H2, L3 is equal to minus G1, G2, G3, L4 is equal to G1, minus g1 g4 l5 is equal to minus g4 h2. So next is identifying whether we have any non-touching loops. See here, there are no non-touching loops because all the nodes are common over here. See, this is a path and all are connected over here only. So then it is we don't have any non-touching loops over here. Okay. Then let us write the Nason's game formula. So there are two non-touching loops. So now let us write the Mason's gain formula. So C of S by R of S equal to P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 whole divided by delta. So what is delta? It is 1 minus L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4 plus L5. Okay, so now we need to write delta 1. So it is forward path, no? All the loops are touching the forward path. Therefore, delta 1 is 1 and delta 2 is also equal to 1. So let us substitute. Now just the substitution is remaining. So P1 is G1, G2, G3 plus P2 is G1, G4 whole divided by 1 plus the loops, loop gains G1, G2, H1 plus G2, G3, H2 plus G1, G2, G3 plus G1, G4 plus G4, H2. So this is the transfer function using Mason's gain formula. So here we have to find the transfer function C of S by R of S for the given signal flow graph. First let us identify the forward path and write the forward path gain. So see, there is only one forward path, 1, G1, G2, G3, G4, which goes from directly input to the output. So these are the gains there. So P1 is equal to G1, G2, G3, G4. Then all are feedback paths. Okay, so then it is not possible to take those. Then we'll see the loop gains, so loops also. See, one loop. So this is one loop, G2 minus H1, G4 minus H3, then G2, G3, G4 minus H4, G1, G2 minus H2. So there are four loops. So first let us write all these things. So forward path gains. So P1 is equal to G1, G2, G3, G4. Next, loop gains. That also I have shown you what are the loops. So I'll just write it down. L1 equal to minus G2 H1. L2 is equal to minus G4 H3. L3 is equal to minus G2, G3, G4, H4, and L4 is equal to minus G1, G2, H2. Next we will write two non-touching loops. So we'll see which are the two non-touching loops over here. What is the meaning of non-touching? It should not have any node in common. So see here, L1 is G2 H1, that is this one. And L2, that is G4 H3. See here, this is over here and this loop is over here. We don't have any nodes in common. So these are two non-touching loops. Then one more, G1, G2 and minus H2. And G4 minus H3. See, these also don't have any node in common. So they are non-touching. All the other loops have node in common. So let us write the loop gains. So first one is L1, L2. You have to just multiply and write it. So G2, H1, G4, H3. One more is L4L2. So it is G4H3, G1, G2, H2. Minus minus it will become plus, no? That is why it is positive. So next let us write the Mason's gain formula. So C of S by R of S is equal to, we have only one forward path, therefore V1 delta 1 by delta. Let us write delta first. Delta is 1 minus the individual loop gains. So L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4 plus L5. We have only L4, no? So this one is extra. Let me just cancel it out here. Sorry for that. Yes. Plus the sum of products of two non-touching loops. So it is L1, L2 plus L2, L4. You can write the gains here. I will directly substitute in the end. Okay. And delta 1. Delta 1 is the delta, or it is the forward path. The loops which don't touch the forward path will remain in the delta equation. That will form delta 1. So here we have only one forward path, and all the nodes are common between that all the loops and the forward path. Therefore, delta 1 is 1 only. Right. So C of S by R of S. Now here I will substitute the values. So numerator will have only the forward path P1. So it is G1, G2, G3, G4. And denominator will have this delta value. So 1 minus all the loops are negative, so everything will come positive. Plus G2H1 plus L2 G4H3 plus L3 G2 G3 G4 H4 plus G1 G2 H2, then all loops over, now non-touching loops, plus G2 H1 G4 H3 plus L4 L2 or L2 L4 G4 H3 G1 G2 H2. So this is the answer for the transfer function. So here we have one more block diagram. So we have to find the transfer function using Mason's gain formula. So the first procedure is to draw the signal flow graph. So first let us number the nodes here, all the summation and takeoff points. So 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4, and C of S. So totally we have 6 nodes, 4 nodes and 1 input node and 1 output node. So we have to draw the signal flow graph, then we have to apply the Mason's gain formula. So let me just draw the signal flow graph first. So let me just list out the nodes over here first. So R of S, then 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5. This is R of S, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is C of S. So let me write the gains. R of S, and it is 1. Between 1 and 2, it is takeoff and summation points, it is 1. Then we have here between 2 and 3, we have a block, which is equal to S plus 4. Between 3 and 4, we have block, that is 10 divided by S into S plus 1. And between 4 and 5, we don't have anything, that is 1. Then one more feedback here from 4 to 3. So that is negative feedback minus 0.5 s, and one more from here 2, 4 to 2. Okay, here that is also a negative feedback minus 1, and this is forward path from 1 to 3 this way, and it is plus 3. So now first let us identify the forward paths, then we will write the forward path gains. So one forward path is straight forward, s plus 4 into 10 by s into s plus 1, see you. This is P1. Next forward path is from your RFS, then 3 and 10 by s into s plus 1 and C of s. These are the two forward paths. Loops also we will see over here. See, one loop is here, 10 by s into s plus 1 and minus 0.5s. One more is s plus 4 into 10 by s into s plus 1 into minus 1. So there are only two loops. So one forward path and two loops. So two forward paths, two loops. So let us write the forward path gains first. So forward path gain. So P1 is equal to S plus 4 into 10 divided by S into S plus 1. Okay, that 10 into S plus 4 divided by S into S plus 1. Second forward path, P2 is equal to 3 into 10 divided by S into S plus 1. This is 30 divided by S into S plus 1. Then the loop gains. So L1 is equal to minus 10 divided by s into s plus 1 into 0.5s, which is equal to minus 5s divided by s into s plus 1. L2 is equal to s plus 4. This is also minus because you have a negative feedback there, okay, into 10 divided by s into s plus 1. So this is equal to minus 10 into s plus 4 divided by s into s plus 1. So C of s, R of s will have P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 divided by delta. What is this delta? Delta is 1 minus L1 and L2. Do we have non-touching loops? So no. See here, this is one loop, this is another loop. They have both the nodes in common, so non-touching. And any loop which is not touching the forward path, this is a forward path, both these loops are touching. This is P2 forward path, that also both the loops are touching. So we have delta 1 and delta 2 also equal to 1. So let us proceed further. So the Mason's gain formula, C of S by R of S, will be equal to two forward paths. So P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 divided by delta. So delta is equal to 1 minus L1 plus L2. Okay. So this will be, we need this, we'll simplify. L1 is 5s. Minus will come plus divided by s into s plus 1. Plus L2 is 10 into s plus 4 divided by s into s plus 1. So simplification here, s into s plus 1 plus 5s plus 10s plus 40 whole divided by s into s plus 1. So this, simplify this, after simplification we get it as s square plus 16s plus 40 whole divided by s into s plus 1. This is delta. So delta 1 we have seen it is equal to 1 because all the loops are touching this delta forward path P1. And delta 2 also is equal to 1 because all the loops are touching the forward path P2 as well. So let us substitute in the equation now. So over here we have C of s by R of s equal to numerator P1, 10 into s plus 4 divided by s into s plus 1 plus P2, delta 1 is 1, 30, P2 is 30, s divided by s into s plus 1, delta 1 is 1, whole divided by delta, we just calculated it, square plus 16s plus 40 divided by s into s plus 1. So simplifying, this denominator gets cancelled. So numerator has 10s plus 40 plus 30 whole divided by square plus 16s plus 40. So this is equal to, I can take, if I take 10 out, s plus 7 divided by square plus 16s plus 40. So this is C of s by R of s. This is the answer. If you want, you can use log diagram reduction and verify the answer.